winds over 300 miles per hour. The highest ever measured. 36 lives lost. Over $1 billion in damages. This is the story of Bridge Creek Moor Tornado, one of the most violent and catastrophic twisters to ever strike America's heartland. Let's start by setting the scene and looking at the meteorological factors that came together to create a situation ripe for severe thunderstorms and tornadoes that day in central Oklahoma. On the morning of May 3, 1999, weather forecasters at the Storm Prediction Center in Norman, Oklahoma, were closely monitoring an area stretching from southern Nebraska down to central Texas. A dry line, which is a boundary separating dry desert air to the west and moist Gulf air to the east, was situated across this region. Ahead of this dry line sat a warm, humid air mass, the kind of atmosphere that can fuel explosive thunderstorm development when it clashes with drier air. Early forecasts called for the possibility of severe storms later that day, with threats like large hail, damaging winds, and isolated tornadoes. However, at this point, meteorologists were underestimating just how volatile the atmospheric setup would become. As the morning hours ticked by, new data started streaming in that caused alarms to go off at the forecast office. Doppler radar detected an intense 100 miles per hour jet stream plunging down from the Pacific Ocean. This provided an extra kick of wind energy and spin in the upper levels of the atmosphere. Crucial ingredients for spinning up intense thunderstorms and tornadoes. Weather balloons launched from the ground also picked up on increasing instability and turning of the winds with height, signs that the atmosphere was becoming more primed for rotating supercell thunderstorms capable of producing tornadoes. By 11:15 a.m., the Storm Prediction Center upgraded the risk level to moderate for much of Oklahoma and parts of surrounding states. Meteorologists warned that the atmospheric setup would provide sufficient shear for a few strong or violent tornadic supercells. As the early afternoon arrived, all the necessary ingredients were coming together. Intense heat and humidity at ground level, strong winds increasing with height, and an approaching dry line to lift the warm, moist air and allow thunderstorms to explode. Forecasters realized a major severe weather event was likely on the horizon. The stage was set for historic storms to unfold. As the afternoon of May 3, 1999 wore on across southwestern Oklahoma, the atmosphere continued becoming more unstable and primed for explosive thunderstorm development. Around 3 to 20 p.m., the first supercell thunderstorm of what would become a historic outbreak began taking shape in Tillman County. While overall atmospheric lift was somewhat lacking initially, intense surface heating over the region helped provide the spark to generate this first rotating storm ahead of the dry line. As the supercell tracked northeastward into Comanche County after 4 p.m., it rapidly intensified in strength. Immense rotating updrafts, drawing from an endless supply of rising humid air from all levels of the atmosphere. Powerful inflow winds at the surface were feeding the towering, spinning thunderstorm with a steady stream of warm, moist air as gigantic rain-cooled downdrafts plunged back towards the ground. This recurring cycle of rising rotating air and crashing downrushes of cooler outflow created an increasingly potent atmospheric fury. Signs of the storm's increasing strength quickly became apparent as it pelted areas of Comanche County with hailstones up to 1.75 inches wide. Shortly after 4:15 p.m., the National Weather Service office in Norman issued its first severe thunderstorm warning for the supercell as it continued intensifying over southern Comanche County. As the storm's rotation accelerated over the next half hour, forecasters realized they were likely dealing with a tornadic supercell. At 4:50 p.m., the first tornado warning was issued by NWS Norman for Comanche, Caddo, and Grady counties. Over the next couple hours, this initial supercell went on to produce an entire family of tornadoes, 14 in total dropping ahead of and being cycled through the main circulation. Of those 14 tornadoes spawned, it was the ninth that would become truly historic. At 6:23 p.m., about 2 miles south-southwest of the town of Amber in Grady County, this latest cone tornado touched down and almost immediately began rapidly intensifying. Within minutes, the newly formed twister had explosively grown from an F4 to F5 intensity and strength as it neared the town of Bridge Creek. In a terrifying display of nature's power, a mobile Doppler radar vehicle documented the highest wind speed ever measured on Earth, an incredible 301 miles per hour, as the tornado plowed directly through Bridge Creek. The scene was one of utter chaos and devastation. Homes were completely swept away, leaving only bare concrete slabs behind. Trees were stripped bare, debarked of all bark and vegetation. Vehicles were thrown massive distances through the air like discarded toys amid the howling vortex. Inside the town, the destruction was catastrophic and heartbreaking. 12 people tragically lost their lives as entire neighborhoods were erased, with the highest number of fatalities occurring in mobile home areas. An additional 39 people suffered injuries as the F5 monster continued growing in size and power after its initial violent impact in Bridge Creek. With winds potentially exceeding 300 miles per hour, this tornado already ranked among the most violent ever recorded. But the worst was still yet to come, as the wedge twister tracked towards more densely populated suburban areas surrounding Oklahoma City. From Bridge Creek, the wedge tornado continued its northeast trajectory into more densely populated suburban areas around Oklahoma City. Entire neighborhoods were scoured from the landscape as homes were obliterated down to their foundations, across a path over a mile wide at times. In the community of Moore, located just south of Oklahoma City, some of the most catastrophic damage took place. 11 people perished and over 290 were injured when the tornado carved through subdivisions like Country Place Estates, Southern Hills, and Eastlake Estates. At Westmore High School, over 400 students and staff took shelter just in time in reinforced areas as the school itself took a direct hit from the tornado's most destructive winds. The tornado then slammed into southeast Oklahoma City around 7:30 p.m. as an F4AF5 monster, demolishing homes, industrial buildings, and businesses. A 36,000-pound freight train car was incredibly hurled nearly a mile through the air. Its path of devastation wasn't done yet. Pushing into the cities of Del City and Midwest City, the tornado killed another 13 people while inflicting F3 to F5 damage to hundreds more homes and businesses. Cars were tossed across Interstate 40 into motels as if they were toys. Finally, after a path of 38 miles over 85 minutes, the tornado dissipated just north of Midwest City, around 7:48 p.m. But the unfathomable destruction it brought would be written in the history books. When the storm had passed, the scale of the catastrophic damage became disturbingly clear. A total of 36 people had lost their lives in the path of the Bridge Creek Moore tornado. 5 more died from indirect causes in the aftermath. Over 600 people were injured, and some never recovered psychologically from the trauma. 8,132 homes and over 1,000 apartments were damaged or completely destroyed across multiple cities and towns. 260 businesses and 7 churches suffered extreme damage as well. In all, losses totaled an astonishing $1.2 billion in 1999, the first billion-dollar tornado on record at the time. The path of incredible devastation stretched for miles, with some areas rendered completely unrecognizable. Houses were simply erased from their foundations, trees were stripped bare, and personal belongings were scattered for over a mile away. Survivors emerged in total shock, struggling to comprehend what they had endured.
"This is the most devastating tornado I have ever seen."
President Bill Clinton quickly issued a major federal disaster declaration to provide emergency resources and aid to the impacted communities. Still, the rebuilding process would take years. In the wake of such an unprecedented tornado, Valuable lessons emerged that helped shape emergency preparedness and disaster response moving forward. First, the advanced warning systems and communication from meteorologists and local media are credited with saving hundreds, if not thousands, of lives that day. Early alerts gave residents critical time to shelter and prepare before the tornado struck populated areas. However, the tornado also highlighted the extreme danger of seeking shelter under highway overpasses, a misconception that had persisted for years. Multiple people died at overpasses struck by the tornado, the result of extreme wind speeds being funneled and accelerated under those confined spaces. It drove home the point that overpasses should never be considered shelters. Damage surveys after the event also revealed sobering realities about substandard residential construction that failed to adequately fortify homes for violent tornado winds. Across Moore and other towns, homes were reduced to mere slabs when their materials were not properly anchored and attached. While no community can ever be fully tornado-proof, steps were taken in the years after 1999 to make the Oklahoma City area more resilient against future tornado strikes. A $12 million project funded the construction of over 6,000 reinforced storm shelters across the metro region by 2003. Tragically, these improved safety measures would be put to the test just a few years later. On May 20, 2013, another violent EF5 tornado carved a path through Moore and surrounding suburbs, in some cases, hitting locations just a couple miles from the 1999 track. Though this tornado also inflicted catastrophic damage, the number of fatalities was substantially lower at 24 people. The shelter construction and tornado preparedness undoubtedly saved many lives that day. The 1999 Bridge Creek Moore tornado also left an indelible mark on meteorology itself. The 301 miles per hour wind measurement remained the highest ever recorded on Earth from a tornado until it was tied by the El Reno tornado in 2013. The Bridge Creek Moore tornado will forever be etched into history as one of the most catastrophic and powerful twisters ever documented. In the span of an hour and a half, it inflicted over $1 billion in damage, killed 36 people directly, and injured over 600 more. Entire neighborhoods were erased, leaving only concrete slabs and scattered debris in the tornado's churning wake. Let me know your thoughts on this event down in the comments. Do you have any experiences with tornado or other violent twisters of this magnitude? As always, if you enjoyed learning about this historic tornado, make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified about future uploads. Thanks for watching.